Now, this is chapter 545. The ruler of the one who sits dangling his feet in a well and uncovers his legs. Chapter 545 means one is the ruling of someone who sits dangling his feet in a well and uncovers his legs. He sits on a corner of a well and he dangles his feet, he hanging out, and then he uncover his legs. What's the rule of it? قال الإمام البخاري رحمه الله تعالى باب أو باب من أدلى رجليه إلى البئر إذا جلس وكشف عن الساقين. قال رحمه الله تعالى حدثنا سعيد بن أبي مريم قال حدثنا محمد بن جعفر عن شريك بن عبد الله عن سعيد بن المسيب عن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه قال خرج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يوما إلى حائط من حوائط المدينة لحاجته وخرجت في أثره فلما دخل الحائط جلست على بابه وقلت لأكونن اليوم بواب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يأمرني فذهب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقضى حاجته وجلس على قف البئر وكشف عن ساقيه ودلاهما في البئر وكشف عن ساقيه ودلاهما في البئر فجاء أبو بكر رضي الله عنه ليستأذن عليه ليدخل فقلت كما أنت حتى أستأذن لك فوقف وجئت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقلت يا رسول الله أبو بكر يستأذن عليك فقال إئذن له وبشره بالجنة إئذن له وبشره بالجنة فدخل فجاء عن يمين النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فكشف عن ساقيه ودلاهما في البئر فجاء عمر فقلت كما أنت حتى أستأذن لك فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إئذن له وبشره بالجنة فجاء عمر عن يسار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فكشف عن ساقيه ودلاهما في البئر فامتلأ القف فلم يكن فيه مجلس ثم جاء عثمان فقلت كما أنت حتى أستأذن لك فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إئذن له وبشره بالجنة معها بلاء يصيبه وبشره بالجنة معها بلاء يصيبه فدخل فلم يجد معهم مجلسا فتحول حتى جلس مقابلهم على شفة البئر فكشف عن ساقيه ثم دلاهما في البئر فجعلت أتمنى أن يأتي أخ لي وأدعو الله أن يأتي به وأدعو الله أن يأتي به فلم يأتي حتى قاموا. قال ابن المسيب فأولت ذلك قبورهم اجتمعت ها هنا وانفرد عثمان رضي الله عنه. قال الشيخ زيد رحمه الله تعالى في هذه القصة العجيبة والحدث المهيب بيان أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتصرف بتوجيهات من ربه جل وعلا جل في علاه له، إذ هذا الخروج إلى الحائط جاء ليظفر هؤلاء الأصحاب الكرام والخلفاء الراشدون بهذه البشارة العظيمة، وهي بشارة بالجنة، فعرفوا ذلك وهم على قيد الحياة، وهي بشارة لا نظير لها، لأنها بشارة من الصادق المصدوق بوحي من الله تبارك وتعالى، ولأنها بالجنة الدار الباقية ذات الكمال والجمال والبقاء الدائم، ففرحوا بذلك واستبشروا، وكل ما قاله النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حق وصدق، أمره ونهيه وأخباره وقصصه. وجاء عثمان الذي هو ثالث الخلفاء الراشدين، وبشره بالجنة ولكن على بلوى تصيبه، وبالفعل أصابته بلوى في خلافته. تصدى له أهل الإجرام الخوارج برئاسة ابن سبأ الذي أسلم نفاقا وكان من اليهود، وأخذ يطوف ويجوب الأقاليم ليهدم الإسلام في خلافة عثمان. فقد تمكن اللئيم ابن سبأ بأن يجمع له ممن سحرهم بكلامه حتى اتفقوا على قتل عثمان، وبالفعل تمت البلوى التي قالها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، فحاصروا منزله برهة من الزمن وتسنموا عليه الدار وقتلوه وهو يتلو كتاب الله تبارك وتعالى بدون ذنب اقترفه. بل الناس في خلافته الطويلة التي هي أطول من خلافة أبي بكر وعمر كانوا في رغد من العيش وأمن وأمان، وكان ينادى في أهل المدينة أن يأتوا إلى بيت المال ليقتسموا الحلل والمواد الغذائية ومنها العسل وليأخذوا أرزاقهم، فصار عيشهم من خير ما يعيشه الناس. ومع هذا اعتدى عليه الخوارج وقتلوه وهو يتلو كتاب الله. فتحققت معجزة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في قوله بشره بالجنة على بلوى تصيبه، وسيعلم الذين قتلوه عاقبة أمرهم إذا قدموا على الله يوم يجازى كل عمل بما عمل ولا يظلم ربك أحدا. This chapter, chapter 545, narration 1151, from Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, rahimahullah, narrated that Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, radiyallahu anhu, said, the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, went out one day to one of the walled gardens of Medina, and I went out after him. When he entered the garden, I sat at his door and said, today I will be the doorkeeper of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even though he hasn't commanded me to do it. The Prophet went and answered a call of a nature and sat on the edge of a wall. He uncovered his legs and dangled them in the wall. Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, came and asked permission to enter. I said, stay where you are until I ask for permission for you. He stopped. I went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, Messenger of Allah, Abu Bakr asked permission to come in. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give him permission and give him the good news of the Jannah, of the garden. He entered and came from the right side of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he uncovered his legs and dangled them in the well. Then Umar came. I said, stay where you are until I ask permission for you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give him permission and give him the good news of the Jannah. Umar came from the left side of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and uncovered his legs and dangled them in the well. The well rim was now full up, and there was no place left to sit. Then Uthman came. I said, stay where you are until I ask permission for you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, give him permission and give him the good news of the Jannah along with an affliction that is to befall him. Give him permission and give him the good news of the Jannah. That means that he will enter Jannah. He is from the people of paradise. Along with an affliction, musibah, tragedy, calamity, that is to befall him. Uthman came in and couldn't find a place with them. Then he moved around until he was facing them on the other side of the well. And he uncovered his legs and dangled them in the well. I began to wish that a brother of mine would come, and I asked Allah to make him come, but he didn't come before they had got up. Ibn al-Musayyib commented, I interpreted that Ibn al-Musayyib, Sa'id al-Musayyib, is the narrator, is the tabi'i, from the great tabi'in. He said, I interpreted this to refer to their graves. They, the Prophet ﷺ, Abu Bakr and Umar, were buried together here, but Uthman was alone. In this narration, there are lessons from that the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum were so full of belief in the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where they used to do whatever they see him doing alayhi salatu wa sallam, even without asking him why. They see the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sit down that way, Abu Bakr so uncover his sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his leg. He sit down next to him, his right side, the same way Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it, without the Prophet commanding him to do that. Even though this is just a normal sitting. This is not salah. This is a normal sitting. But yet Abu Bakr, he did exactly the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. Then Umar, the same thing. Then Uthman, the same thing. It's because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them that true belief that whatsoever the Prophet ﷺ is doing is haq. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best one to follow, the best example. Allah chosen him, made him the best of a human, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So all his actions should be the best. They have this sound aqidah, so they do what the Prophet ﷺ, they see the Prophet ﷺ doing it. No objection, no questions, nothing. And this was their way. You remember the sound hadith. Prophet was praying, leading salah, dhuhr or asr, and in the middle of the prayer, he took off his shoes. Sahaba, they took off their shoes. Prophet didn't talk to them, didn't tell them anything. So when they finished salah, Prophet, he asked them, why you did? They say, رَأَيْنَاكَ خَلَعْتَنَا عَلَيْكَ فَخَلَعْنَاهَا. We saw you, all the Messenger of Allah, you took off your shoes and we took off. That's all they needed. Prophet ﷺ did it, they do it. He didn't do it, they leave it. Allahu Akbar. That's why Allah honored them. They were, before they become Muslim, from the worst of a human being. Idol worshipping. Burying children dead, alive. Their children alive. Killing one another. Poverty, lack of safety, ignorance. They were very famous in that life. Prophet ﷺ came to them with Islam. Within less than 30 years, they became the strongest government on earth. On earth, everywhere. Everywhere on earth. There were empires. Those within 30 years, they gone. How can that happen? How can that happen? How many years passed? Hundreds of years. Maybe thousands, and some people, they don't make it, never. They say that didn't happen in the history. People to make that civilization, to make that within that time, they need generation after generation after generation to make it. The historians mention that. It doesn't come that fast. So, al-muhim, it's not just being strong. No. Not being strong militarily, no. No, that was not the case. How can they be strongest in the military? And they didn't have even weapon. They were less number. They were in... No. That was because of what they were upon of haq. So, sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim, because they adhere to the Messenger's way, alayhi salam, Allah honored them. Before akhir, Allah make them the leaders of this worldly life. And their government exists how long? Some of us, we don't know the history. Many countries on the earth today used to be Muslims. Many countries used to be Muslims, controlled by Muslims. Today, even they try to dismiss, to eliminate, to hide anything related to Islam. While this country used to be a Muslim country, rather the capital of the Muslim countries. like Spain, India, and many parts of Africa, not all of it, and other areas, for instance. Al-Muhim, ala kullin. So the Sahaba, because Allah guided them, they believe the Messenger Sallam the way they should, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the ways of khair for them. So the three Sahabi, whenever they see Prophet sitting, they sit down. The way he's sitting, alayhi salam. He took off his shoes, they took off his shoes, alayhi salatu wa salam. Tayyib, this is how the Sahaba used to have confidence in the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. Then, from the ilm in this hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahabi, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, when he tell him, Abu Bakr asking permission, give them good news, give him the good news, and let him come in and tell him that he will have Jannah, he will enter Jannah. Allahu Akbar, someone on earth, and he has the good news, he's from the people of Jannah, he's protected from hellfire, he will have Jannah, where there is no pain, no stress, no grief, no worry, no sickness, no hunger, no thirst, no harm, rather all kinds of peace of joy, of peace of mind, joyful life, forever, unimaginable, beyond our imagination, beyond our imagination, forever. Someone who was given that, you have the protection, you have the safety. How great is that? So, they have good news. Abu Bakr, and then Umar, and then Uthman. When Prophet ﷺ came to Uthman, he ﷺ added something, some other ilm. The first ilm, you will enter Jannah, is knowledge related to the hereafter. Plus he mentioned another knowledge with Abu Bakr, with Uthman, related to this worldly life, that he will go through affliction. Calamity may happen to him. In another narration, sound narration, Uthman said, Allahu al-Musta'an. Allahu al-Musta'an. And that musibah was, that affliction was, the ulama Ahl-Sunnah mentioned, is the khawarij, fitna of khawarij, who were created by and founded by that hypocrite, a Jewish man. His name is Abdullah ibn Saba, who hate Islam so much. And he said, how can you fight Islam? He found the best way to fight is to claim he's a Muslim. And within that he changed. He make the people against the Muslim ruler. He divided them. He brings innovations in aqidah, innovations in ibadah. Everything changed. And subhanallah, you can hear now one someone who's alive. You can, if you want to hear, you hear his video. A Christian man. Today he's alive. Last time I know he was alive. In our time. He's on YouTube telling people, he addressing non-Muslims. He say, enter Islam. Not because of Allah. Enter Islam to fight within it. He said, this is the best way to fight Islam. He said, enter Islam, do the minimum things to show that you are a Muslim. And then time go by, we change, and he said, the Ka'b people, instead of going Hajj to make into Makkah, we change, we make it Safana. This money being given to the Arab, Saudi airplanes and airlines and going to Saudi Arabia, each one who performed Hajj, close to 5,000, he said, he even aware of it. And maybe that's a few years back, now it's more than that. He said, we just charged them with going them, sending them to Safana, making the Kaaba there, just 2,500, and the money goes back to us. And then he said, one day, we announce that we, he said, they denounce Islam. And he said, all the Western media like that. Everywhere they publicize that this, they left Islam. He said, this is the way to fight. Someone is alive. Alive. In our time, you hear him, you see him, you understand. English speaker. So, this Abdullah ibn Sawal Yahud has that idea. And he didn't start it. He didn't start it. It was at the time Prophet ﷺ, Munafiqun, a group of the Jewish. قال الطائفة من أهل الكتاب آمنوا بالذي أنزل على الذين آمنوا وجه النهار واكفروا آخره لعلهم يرجعون. A group of Jewish in Medina, they gather. They have this secret meeting. Allah knows that. They said, enter Islam in the morning and disbelief in the evening. So they may return. Those Muslims may leave it. So in the morning, they claim they're Muslims. Oh, Islam is good. They say they are the people of the book, the Jewish. They find out Islam. They are people of knowledge. They find out Islam. Then time go by, they announce. What is their goal? That the layman, the ignorant, to say, oh, these people are people of knowledge. Jewish people, they have a book. They enter Islam willingly. And now they find out that there is a deficiency in it. There has to be problem in Islam. We don't know. That's the way they think. But Allah guides who He wills. So this Abdullah ibn Saba Yahud, he was that famous munafiq. And he's the founder of Rafida, Shia. The Rafida, originally he's Abdullah ibn Saba Yahud. The Rafida today you hear, their founder is that Yahudi. That Yehudi, he was the one who behind spreading lies against Uthman. Spreading lies against Uthman bin Affan. Say, Uthman, he is not fair in ruling. Uthman, he welcomed his close relative, Banu Umayyah. He gave this one leadership. He gave this one, and he showed them people shubha. He said, Uthman, he made Muawiyah, who is from Banu Umayyah, a leader of Sham. How come? It's because of nationalism. He gives this picture, which is lie, falsehood. Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the son of the leader of Quraysh, Abu Sufyan, who was very wise, then becomes Sahabi, used to write revelation for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muawiyah, Abu Bakr make him a leader of an area. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he increased it. He gave him more leadership. Umar. Abu Bakr first. Abu Bakr is one who assigned Muawiyah to be a leader in the area of Palestine. I don't remember now. Then Umar made it more leadership, give him more authority on a larger land. Then Uthman, he followed them. He increased it. So they showed the layman, the ignorant, what Uthman did. Uthman, he didn't do with anything but what those Sahaba did before him. Why you don't blame Abu Bakr for that? Why you don't blame Umar for that? Because they are not getting sympathy from the ignorant who is affected by nationalism, tribalism. They are not getting hand from, in the case of Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr is not from Banu Umayyah. Then again from Umar, he's not from Banu Umayyah. But they look and they level him, Uthman, because. So this is Shubha. And Al-Bati, they look for Shubha. They look for doubtful mar. So anyway, those people, they accepted. Especially when people are said to your leader, he's not fair in when it comes to dividing the wealth, dividing the positions, the leadership. Who human being, all of them, they are there for worldly life. And this is the tool the Khawarij always they use. This king, this leader, he didn't distribute the wealth fairly. He make a leader such such. He make this such such. This is where they cannot even hear. All the time. He make his son. He make this one. He make his this one. He make all what you talk about worldly life. Let him take all of it. Protected the country from general calamity, which leave no one. Yeah, if general calamity comes, this leader you complain about, he is the minister. He will not be minister and you will not be either. You will eat one another. You kill one another. The hikmah and this, let him have his ministry and worship your Lord. Make your business. Have your family peace. Things going smoothly. This world life would disappear anyway. No, they don't think that way. So the Khawarij, they use always to corrupt the system. They expose the weaknesses, the shortcoming, the mistakes, the sin of the rulers, if there is any. If there is no any, they lie on, like they did in the case of Uthman. So they lie against Uthman. And until today, they continue lying. There is an Ikhwani, Muslim Brotherhood, this group who are behind all calamity our time. Ikhwan Muslimun, one of them, when the previous Egyptian leader, Mohamed Morsi, he became the leader of Egypt. One of the Ikhwani, Muslim Brotherhood, he gave him advice, what he considered being advice. It's in YouTube, you can see images, you can see him too. Now he's in a jail. Last information I hear is in a jail. Alhamdulillah, to be in a jail, not to be out of it, until he becomes Salafi. Wallahi, Allah keep him there until he changed his bad aqidah, corruption aqidah. He say he talking to Morsi. He say, "Oh Morsi, I'm giving you advice. Don't be like Uthman. If you be like Uthman, you destroy Egypt and all on Islam. Allah will ask you the day of judgment." That's the way even he make his finger. Don't be Uthman. Be like Abu Bakr. Subhanallah. Hada haula ahya. They are alive now. We hear them, we see them. When Ahlul Sunnah say, "Ya akhi, Ahlul Sunnah," what they mention, which we didn't attain, we're not there, we have to trust it. They say this group was created by Munafiq, Abdullah bin al-Sab al-Yahud, this day with the Fat Islam, Rawafi was created by this one, Khawarij was this. You didn't attend, but the ulama who mentioned are Ahlul Insaf wa Adil. Those who mentioned are the truthful ones. Imagine if we see that with our own eye then. What the ulama mentioned, now we see it. People talking out there, saying bad about Uthman, who Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned with revelation from Allah, that is from the people of Jannah. Anyway, so when they spread these lies, it end up those people attacking from many of Muslim lands, attacking Uthman. And they gather in Medina, thousands. Some narration 2,000 more. From Egypt, from Iraq. All fitness from Iraq. Prophet mentioned Iraq, a place of fitna. Yes, there are good people from it. When there are Ahl Sunnah, there are ulama. But many times fitna come from that area as well. Way back. So they came and they reject Uthman to go to the masjid, to the Prophet's masjid, to lead the Salah and his Muslim Khalifa. And they already spread lies. People accepted, only accepted the Sahaba and those who followed them. Al-Muhim, at the end they killed Uthman radiallahu anhu, while he was reciting Quran. And while he was fasting in his own house, after they stopped him from going even to the masjid, not he pray, he lead people, but even praying behind them, they rejected. Sahaba who was there, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, was to them calamity. It was to them calamity. And they presented, because they become between two, between Uthman, who say, "Don't fight. Don't do anything. If you obey me," Uthman says, "don't do anything. Leave these guys do what they want. Don't do anything." Sahaba came. "We want to fight. We want to make them." Uthman, he said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, "Who to fight? These are thousands. They are Muslims. They have a weapon. They already entered the city. They're from Muslim country. What can you? Fighting means Muslim killing one another." Uthman, he said, "No. Don't, no one fights." And on the other hand, Khawarij, that's what they're doing it. So the Sahaba, they really needed, those who were in Medina at that time, they extremely needed sabr and patience. You have to obey the leader. And the Sahaba, the Prophet said, already mentioned, Uthman will have affliction, musibah. So Uthman remained patient until they killed him. رضي الله تعالى عنه. And then, so this is also from the ilm. Another sound hadith, Prophet ﷺ was on mountain of Uhud. And the mountain of Uhud shake. Prophet ﷺ said, oh, is Uhud, stop. Nothing, no one is on you but a prophet, Siddiq, or Shahidan, and two martyrs. Two people who will be killed in the cause of Allah. Who were with the Prophet ﷺ? Abu Bakr, and who? Umar and Uthman. So Abu Bakr is Siddiq. And Umar and Uthman are Shuhada, Shaheed. How Umar became Shaheed? He was leading Fajr prayer in the Medina, Prophet's Masjid. He was the Khalifa, and he was killed by fire worshipper. Fight those from Persians, Furs government. What was the name? Abu Lu'lu al-Majusi, fire worshipper. He came Medina. He said he is helping, he's serving one of the Sahaba. And his goal was not. His goal was to kill the Muslim Khalifa. Because he considered he destroyed his empire. And until today, that's why the Shia, they hate the Sahaba. Because they consider they destroyed their empire. That's why the Shia, they have 12 imams. 12 imams. They believe they perfect. These 12 imams, who are they? Who are they? These 12 imams, they say it's the family of Prophet ﷺ. But they don't take all the family of Prophet ﷺ. They only take Hussein's children. Because Hussein married the Persian queen. The one, the founder of the Persian Empire. The first one, his son, the third one, grandson, you call? His daughter, who was queen. Hussein married. Then his children, only his children are those 12 imams, they claim. Where is the children of other children of Hussein himself? They don't call them ma'sumin. Where are the children of Hassan? Where are the children of Ali himself? Where are the children of... No. So they claim they are the family of Prophet ﷺ. These are the family of Prophet ﷺ, but they are not doing that for the family of Prophet ﷺ. Why, if it's the family of Prophet ﷺ, Hassan is not the family of Prophet ﷺ, why you don't hear them? Why you don't have the descendants of Hassan, anyone? How about the Ali himself? The father of Hussein. He's the family of Prophet ﷺ. He's the father of Hussein. Where's his children, other children? Hussein himself, he has other children from other women. Why only the children from this queen or from Persian queen? Why are they so honored to be perfect? So this is not for Allah. And the ulama, they mention. And it's very logic to understand. The same family, one group from one mother, one woman kills, are honored. The children from the same father, her husband, Hussein has other children. No. His brother Hassan has other children. No. Ali himself has other children. No. And then they use that in the family of Prophet ﷺ. Al-Muhim. So they kill Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, shaheedan. The tabi'i, Sa'id al-Musayyib, the great tabi'i, who his father, alhamdulillah, became sahabi, but he used to be before that the leaders of Quraysh. Even he was one of the three who was with Abu Jah, Abu Talib. When Abu Talib was about to die, uncle Prophet, went to call him to Tawheed. Three kuffar were there, calling him to shirk. Abu Jahl was one of them. Sa'id al-Musayyib, father, was one of them. They calling him to die upon shirk. Prophet was calling him to Tawheed. Alhamdulillah, later he became Muslim. Al-Muhim. It means the Sa'id Musayyib father, not Abu Talib. So in this hadith, Prophet mentioned about the unseen. He mentioned about unseen, something in this world life, and it happened the way he mentioned, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
many ways to prove Messenger was a messenger of Allah. One way is the information he talked about related to the future, and it happened the way he mentioned, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Prophet, many information. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he said to when he saw Hassan, young boy, very young, crawling, he said, "Inna ibni hada sayyid, wa la'alla Allah an yusliha bihi bayna fi'atayn 'azimatayn min al-muslimin." My son, this one, Hassan, not Hussein. This is for Hassan. He said he's a leader. And Allah may put peace because of him between two great groups from the Muslims. And you know what Hassan did, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when Ali was killed by Khawarij, Hassan became his leader, Ali's position, leading those Muslims. Ali was leading, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And then there was fitna, also created by munafiqun. Created by munafiqun. Munafiqun are those who were behind killing Uthman, Abdullah ibn Sab al-Yahud. Then it has impact. They continue. وَإِلَى يَوْمِنَا هَذَا أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ عَلَى الْمُسْلِمِينَ هُمَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ. Until today, the worst people to the Muslims, not the kuffar, is the munafiqun, hypocrite. Therefore, don't ever accept innovations. Don't ever accept innovations. If you truly love Islam, hate the innovations. And have doubt the one who making innovations. Especially after he is advised. He is proved this is innovation. It's not from the deen of Islam. He continues doing ittahimu ala al-Islam. Fear from him. Because this is amal al-munafiqun. This is the way they can do it. They say they Muslim. They are not Muslims. And then they change the deen. They change. They make a kind of ibadah. They cry in salah. They say, Allahu Akbar. Islam, let we defend Islam. Wallahi al-azim. One time I conclude with this one. Subhanallah. I was reading maqal in the website. A'udhu billah. This person, he says, he talking about the government. He say, oh youth, attack the governments. Look what the innovation they make. Like the university. There is chairs in the university. How you accept chair to be? Is innovation the chair? When you go to the class, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أخي هذا كافر ما هو مسلم. And he put big fitna. Big, if you hear a sweet talk, Prophet ﷺ said, no innovation. Innovation. And then he bring a chair. He say, throw the chair to the teacher tomorrow when you go to the college. Na'am, that's Islam. Prophet Ibrahim, what he did, he destroyed the, these are idols. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. So, ya akhi, you don't know what those people are. Therefore, when it comes to the religion, you don't take the religion from everyone. La. Some people, they say they're Muslims. Allahu a'lam who they are. It doesn't mean that everyone who innovate is originally munafiq, is hypocrite. La, hada laysa bi sahih. Na'udhu billahi min dhalik. Now, it doesn't mean that everyone who innovate is hypocrite. Means he knowingly changing the deen of Allah. La. Now, the one who does that is not Muslim. No, they don't. Some of them, they're ignorant. Rather, they want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They want to worship Allah better. So, that's yes. Even you remember those sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, who pledged that some one of them not to break fasting, one of them not to sleep nighttime, one of them not to get married, one of them not to eat meat. Why? For the sake of Allah. So yes, good intention may bring sometimes the innovations. They may say, as they said to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, ma aradna illa al-khayr. When he saw them making innovations, sahabi, he said, these people, what are you making? They say, wallahi, we don't want to, but good. Our intention is good. And until today, you see those people saying, they're doing celebration party because they love the message. Some of them are truth. There may be some of them who are not truthful in that. They're doing intentionally to change. You know the birthday, celebration for the birth person. There are kuffar who pay money on it to celebrate in some Muslim land. They kuffar. They are not even Muslim. They pay money of it. Openly. People who are known to fight Islam cannot hear when they come to those things, they are on the front line. paying, gathering those people, and they make celebrations and all this. Why? You even don't pray, you don't fast. How come you doing these things? When it comes to this innovation, you are strong. When it comes to the building graves, this man is strong. Pay a lot of money. Subhanallah, you have to question. Why are you strong in innovation? You are not strong on sunnah. Subhanallah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-afi. Hada wa allahu alam wa sallam. Na'am, akhi. La raib, na'udhu billah. Yes, jazakallah, sahaba, they didn't make innovation. They wanted to do good, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah azza wa jalla. This is ijtihad, but the Prophet, he corrected them. Radiallahu alayhi salatu wa salam, he corrected them. It's known, aqidah al-sunnah wal-jama'ah. Sahaba as individual, they are not perfect. Sahabi can mistake. Sahabi as individual can mistake. If you believe the Sahabi doesn't mistake, you are not upon the manhaj of Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. You are not under a sound aqid. You are in danger aqid. Sahaba as individual can mistake. As individual, Sahabi can mistake. But you don't say he mistake until you prove he mistake. Sahaba can make ijtihad. Na'am. So the ulama, the same thing. Alim is not perfect. Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا حَكَّمَ الْحَاكِمُ إذا حكم الحاكم فاجتهد فأصاب فله أجران وإن أخطأ فله أجر. The judge, the alim, if he struggle and he judge the issue and he corrects, he get 2 reward. He mistake, he get 1 reward. So either the case, they get the reward. Those who try, they are qualified to struggle. But yes, mistake can happen from individual. But you have to first affirm it. You have to, there has to be mistake. The person can mistake, doesn't mean he mistake. Yeah, Imam Bukhari can mistake, he can forget. Because some people, they refute the hadith. They say, you know what, Imam Bukhari is a human being. How we accept every hadith, he can mistake. Yes, he can mistake, he's a human being. But prove that he mistake. You have to prove that he mistake. Otherwise, origin, the sound, alim, sound, the sahabi, he's upon haqq. So you don't say because he can mistake, he mistake. But if it happened, he mistake, he mistake. But the Sahaba, of course, the mistake of Sahaba, it's not like a mistake of anyone else. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum khayruhum. The good thing is if they have no good but being a companion of the Messenger, that's alhamdulillah enough. Radiallahu ta'ala. So we don't go to extreme to say bad about the Sahaba. Nor on the other hand, to make ghulu, like the Rawafid, and they claim, no, Sa'a'imay ma'asumun, Ali is ma'asum, Hussein is ma'asum. We don't believe Hussein is ma'asum, nor Ali is ma'asum. Radiallahu anhumah. But on the other hand, to say he wrong, he mistake, you have to bring mistakes. You have to bring the proof. Wallahu alam, wa sallallahu wa sallam, nabiyyina Muhammad.